Hello, my fellow T-Birders. Today we're looking at a 6566 Thunderbird passenger side window motor. And in the car it would not work, and when you hit the switch, you would see the dome lights dim. And that's an indication, whenever you look for a draw on the system, that's an indication that power is getting to the motor, but the motor's not pulling the window up or down. If your switch were bad or there were a broken wire or something, then you wouldn't get a dimming light. You wouldn't have a draw on your system. So when you hit the switch and you get a draw, a dimming light, that tells you that power is getting to the motor. Anyway, this motor was stuck. We took it off the regulator and it worked once we had it out of the door. And so I'm going to show you how to fix these when they get stuck like that. So I've already pulled some of the grease out of it. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and take this off. And then I'm gonna pull the head of the motor off. Okay, so now I took that out. This is an adjustment bolt that puts preload on the motor. That came out of here. I took that out. And then you gotta pull these out. I got a 5/16 here, pull these out. Sometimes you have to cut away the rubber around here. Okay, now we're here. I got the motor and the vise. I took these out. Excuse me. They go in here. Right? I took them out. Both sides. I was careful to hold the head of the motor on. And then I took it on a wire wheel. I've got a wire wheel with stiff bristles, and it just, you have to get this rubber off or else it sticks, it's stuck on. So once you got that off, then this thing is loose. But you don't want to pull it off yet. Here, hold that, Craig, please. Back up a little bit. What you want to do is you want to hold the motor itself, the worm gear and the armature, into the motor. You don't want that to come out, because if you pull that out, then the commutator brushes will pop out and then you're screwed. So if you keep this in here and you pull this out, this is probably stuck. There we go. There we go. See, there's the armature. And this is what goes bad. Let me have that. This is what goes bad. They corrode around here. And then they stick. And you don't want to damage this O-ring. Now, if you had an O-ring kit, you could probably replace that. But what we're going to do is we're going to clean this. We're going to clean inside there. We're going to clean all this out. I'll probably glass bead it. And we're going to clean it all out and then lube it and lube that, clean this off, probably take it to a wire wheel, clean all this off, and then it'll work properly. Now look at the motor inside is like new. So I cleaned the shaft, as you can see, clean the gear, nice and clean in there. Everything is nice and free. Again, don't pull this thing out of here. That'll be it for you. You won't get it back together again, unless you know something I don't. And then this thing, we glass beaded it. And then I greased it. And then this just goes back on. Like that. And you put it over the seal, like that. And that's it, see? It's on, and then you line up the holes and put the screws in. Now I'm going to run it, and when you run it, you hook negative. Here it is, sorry, to black, the female, and you hook power to either side, the yellow or the red, doesn't matter. Sounds good. Go the other way now. Great. This is usually the case. They get stuck because they're not used. They get dirty, clogged up. And it's just as simple as taking them out and taking them apart. Remember, they're real easy to take apart, but you have to hold this in place while you pull the head of the motor off so that you don't pull the armature out. Once you pull the armature out, you're screwed. Okay? So about adjusting this, you know, we had this off, and this is a critical adjustment. You can turn it down until it stops, but you can't leave it there. You have to actually back it off. You can't have a preload on this. Preload means you got a little pressure on it. You can't. So you got to take it down to where it stops, and then you got to back it off. But let's run it, and I'll show you what'll happen when you take it down to its stop. Hear that? That's where the motor stops. Right there. So I just go back it off until it sounds better. Right there. Which is probably at the most an eighth of a turn. And that's it, right there. It's then you put the nut on and you put a screwdriver in there and you hold it in position while you tighten the nut. Okay, now I'm gonna put the motor back onto the regulator. Now this is the right-hand side. This is the passenger door. So you see how the spring is. I'm backing this off towards here and the spring is unloosening. And now I'm straightening the regulator out and it's under pressure. See, it's under pressure. Okay, that's how you want it. You want it under pressure like that. See how I'm straightening it out and it's under pressure. Okay, I got the motor on the regulator, passenger side, 6566. And see, I've got this under pressure, see? It's under pressure. See, when I let go of it, it slams back. That's how this has to be loaded. There is no other way, okay? Under pressure, and then you work the motor. Go ahead. See, stop. That's it. Now it's loaded and it's set. That's it. You put it in the car this way, you plug it in while you're putting it in, and if you need to move the motor and regulator, if you need to move it in a different position, you use the switch. Okay, now I got the motor and the regulator in the door, and I'm going to show you how this thing works. Ready? Sounds good, works good. Now, I'm working it with a battery jumper right straight to the motor, so it's gonna work differently once it's plugged into the car, because it's gonna have to go through the electrical system of the car, so it'll work slower. But it works well now, and it will continue to work well.